There's always a perfect buyer willing to pay top dollar for your home. This is a really important topic if you debated about or even thought about selling your home this year. Before I get into it, as always, if you're thinking about selling your home this year and you're curious of what your home might be worth in the current market conditions, you can use our online market evaluation system at localmarketvalue.com to get a price range for your home and what you might be able to sell it for. But to the point here, how do you sell your home for top dollar in today's market? Let's jump into it. I'm Kevin Schumacher, EXP Realty. I've been helping homeowners for the last 26 years up and down the Colorado Front Range. And I really do believe that there's a specific buyer segment for every home. And there are advanced ways to target those buyers, allowing you to get top dollar when selling your home. They'll overpay for the right home. So if we know that's one of the strategies to help you sell your home for the most amount of money, the question is how do we do it? How do we find the right buyer for your home? I'm gonna give you some just simple tips. One of the tips I always do with potential home sellers when we meet and tour their home is ask this one question. When you bought your home, what were the top three things that stood out to you? What were the top three reasons what made you fall in love with this home and choose this home over all other homes that were available in the market at that time? And I listened carefully because what I found out over the last 26 years is that those features that attracted you to your home are usually the same exact or very similar to who the ideal buyer is for your home. Those features also play a key role when describing your home to the buyer pool. When you're marketing your home, which is probably the most important facet of selling your home, is the marketing plan, because that's how you get your home in front of the right buyers. Having that information is critical. That allows us to find the right buyer. So once I ask those questions, hey, what are the three things that you love that made you choose this home or all the other homes? The very next question, what are the three things about your home right now that you've enjoyed the most? And what I'm looking for here is are there any changes, additions, renovations, whatever it is. Again, having the three things they love when they bought their home and having the three things that they loved since they lived in their home. When we take those items that allow me to really find what I call our buyer profile, the unique buyer profile. And what that basically means is when I know those features, I can then identify that and ask, okay, what most likely is the buyer for this home? Who is that? What's that buyer look like? And then when I have that information, we can run advertising directly to that profile of person and who are more than likely willing and able and wanting to buy your home, who align to the features, the amenities, and the condition of your home. And when you can do that, then you can get your home positioned in front of the right buyers. And that's when you as a home seller can maximize your home's value. This is one of the most critical things when people list their home. Usually they have this flow of traffic that comes into their home and sometimes doesn't result in an offer. And people say, well, why is that? Well, because those people were just looking. There wasn't a specific feature. It wasn't the right home for them. When you find the right buyer and you're positioning your home for marketing to the ideal profiled buyer, that is where the magic happens for home sellers. So imagine this. You only had to show your home to 10 buyers versus 50 buyers. But the 10 buyers who came in absolutely knew that that was the layout, or there's a feature or multiple features that they absolutely are dying for in a home. Those were their hot buttons. And that's the amazing thing is because that's when you can start positioning buyers against each other to help drive up the price of your home. Everything that I do when I work with potential home sellers are strategies for maximizing your home's value. Selling your home for the most amount of money possible, so at the end of the day, you can put the most amount of money in your pocket. So just a little tip that I wanted to share with you guys today. So if you're thinking about selling your home, this is an important one. I'll tell you really a quick story, but before we get to that, you know, if you're thinking about selling your home this year, if you've got questions about what your home is worth, maybe how to get your home prepared for sale, when's the best time to list your home? Just about any questions about the home selling process, we absolutely would love to help you. You can go to localmarketvalue.com. When you get there, you can actually click on the phone number that will call me directly, or you can simply fill out the home evaluation tool on the site and get a range of value for your home to give you an idea of what your home is currently worth. No cost, no obligation. If you're just looking to sell now, down the road, or just curious, I'm happy to provide you the information you're looking for. Quick story, when you can find the perfect home, many times there's features of that home which make it unique. and there's a buyer that has a specific need, and when a home matches that buyer's need or desire, and is sometimes rare, buyers will tend to overpay for that specific home because of that specific feature. We understand that buying is a very emotional process, so people fall in love with a home and ultimately will justify logically why it's okay to pay more for the right home. But again, when you find the perfect buyer for your home, you have all the negotiation tips, all the negotiation chips as a potential seller, because we know they fell in love with your home and your property. The features, the conditions, something specific about the home, because we write your ad, we market your home, we showcase the features that you share with us in the very beginning. So just to recap, finding the perfect buyer for your home, it starts with these two questions. First question is, what were the top three features of your home that led you to choose it over the competition? Secondly, what's the three things that you most enjoy currently about your home? When you know these hot buttons, there's a high probability and likelihood that your home is going to attract a similar buyer to yourself. So what do I mean by that? Let's say you bought your home because of the school district. There's a high chance that another buyer is going to buy your home because of that school district. That's appealing about the property. You most likely is going to be appealing to the right buyer who's looking for a home. So we're going to make sure we advertise, market, and promote the school district, because that's going to give us the highest probability in finding the right buyer. This eliminates unnecessary showings because you're showing your home to the right buyer, which ultimately helps you attract the most amount of money. So let's just—that's just a little quick tip. What you love about your home, and using those exact features to help you position your home when you're ready to sell. I hope you find that all this information is valuable. If you have any questions, please reach out. If you're thinking about selling your home, you have questions on what it's worth, go to localmarketvalue.com. Use our home evaluation tool that compares recent sales of homes similar to yours to determine a range of values, so you can get an idea of the value of your home in today's market conditions. If you have any questions, or you're looking for an exact number on what you could list your home for this summer, click the phone number in the top right corner, and I'd be happy to share with you more strategies on how we can maximize your current equity position when selling your home.